अस्सलाम वालेकुम, माय नेम इज़ मिनाहिल मकसूद। आई एम रोल नंबर 139 फ्रॉम ग्रुप नंबर 26। आवर ग्रुप टॉपिक इज़ एक्यूट एंड क्रॉनिक रेनाइटिस एंड आई एम रिप्रेजेंटिंग एलर्जिक रेनाइटिस फ्रॉम दैट टॉपिक। सो व्हाट इज़ एलर्जिक रेनाइटिस? एलर्जिक रेनाइटिस इज़ ऑल्सो नोन एज हे फीवर। इट इज़ द टाइप ऑफ द इन्फ्लेमेशन इन द नोज विच अकर्स वेन इम्यून सिस्टम ओवर रिएक्ट्स टू द एलर्जेंस प्रेजेंट इन द एयर। It is an immunoglobulin E mediated hypersensitivity disease of the mucous membrane of nasal airways, characterized by number of the symptoms: sneezing, watery nasal discharge, itching, and the nasal congestion. So we can broadly classify rhinitis as the inflammation of the nasal mucosa. It is a common disorder that affects up to 40% of the population. It is the most common disorder and the most common type of the chronic rhinitis. In the past, allergic rhinitis was considered to be a disorder localized to the nose and the nasal passages. But nowadays, current evidence suggests that it may represent a systemic airway disease involving the entire respiratory tract. Types of the allergic rhinitis are the seasonal and the perennial. Seasonal allergic rhinitis usually occur in the spring, summer, and the fall. Like tree pollens in the summertime from March to June, and wheat pollen affecting the people during the summer from May to August, and mold spores affecting the people during the late summer and the autumn months from August to October. While perennial allergic rhinitis can occur throughout the year. The causes, as I told earlier, are the allergens like pollen and the spores, animal skin or the dust mites, etc. The symptoms are the red watery swollen eyes, nasal congestion, rhinorrhea, that is the watery nasal discharge, runny or the itchy nose, mouth breathing during the sleep, sneezing. The diagnosis can be done by the allergy testing through the skin prick test and the serum antigen specific IgE. Why we are doing serum antigen specific IgE? Because it is the hallmark of the allergic rhinitis and it is the evidence of the specific IgE to a relevant allergen. I would like to tell some pathophysiology of the allergic rhinitis. In allergic rhinitis, numerous inflammatory cells like mast cells, CD4 positive T cells, B cells, macrophages, eosinophils, basically infiltrate the nasal lining upon exposure to the specific allergen and release cytokines that promote the immunoglobulin E. So we can test and we can diagnose it through this IgE antigen specific test. We can also classify the allergic rhinitis according to the symptom duration and the severity of the symptoms into the intermittent, persistent, mild, and the moderate severe. In the intermittent type of the allergic rhinitis, the symptoms could be longer for less than 6 weeks, and in persistent, symptoms can continue throughout the year. In the mild type of the allergic rhinitis, there is a normal sleep, no impairment of the daily activities, normal work or the school, no bothersome symptoms. While in the moderate and the severe, there could be the abnormal sleep or impairment of the daily activities and problems at the school or the work, or so they are the troublesome symptoms. How to avoid the allergic reaction triggers? We can avoid by keeping the windows closed when pollen levels are high. Wear glasses or sunglasses to keep the pollen out of the eyes. Use mite-proof padding to avoid exposure to the dust mites. Use a dehumidifier in dust-prone areas. After touching an animal, wash your hands before touching your face. Stay away from other allergens like cigarette smoke or the cleaning solutions like detergents, etc. The treatment could involve first-line agents as antihistamines and the intranasal corticosteroids that are the first-line treatment for the allergic rhinitis. Sodium chromoglycate, ipratropium bromide, and decongestants are alternatives or add-on treatments. Drug treatment should be selected according to the severity, frequency, duration of the symptoms. Drug treatment should be tailored to the person's individual need and according to its adverse effects profile. So here I am representing a case study. It is March and Mr. J.A., which is a university student, and he comes to a community pharmacy to buy something for his runny nose, and his symptoms last from 8 weeks, which he thought was a usual cold, and he was self-medicating with some medications. So his symptoms are the runny nose, frequent sneezing, and the runny eyes, and these symptoms are referring to the allergic rhinitis. So I am discussing the SOAP notes. The subjective includes age, chief complaint, history. As age is the 20 years and chief complaint is runny nose, eyes, and frequent sneezing. And the history includes porphyria, childhood asthma. I would like to tell about porphyria. Porphyria is basically debilitating symptoms that start with the severe pain in the abdomen and also involve the back and the limbs. Past medications include salbutamol inhaler and beclomethasone inhaler as he was having childhood asthma. He has a history of childhood asthma. Current medications which he is using is the Vicks Sinex nasal spray and the Sudafed tablets. In objective, there are the no vital signs are given and the no lab reports are provided. Assessment, Mr. J is showing symptoms of seasonal allergic rhinitis as symptoms appear in the March, which is showing that he is suffering from the allergy of the pollen grains. The severity of the allergy might be mild persistent, but as he was using cold remedies for 8 weeks, so that resulted in rebound nasal congestion. I would like to mention here that cold symptoms are slightly different from the allergic rhinitis, as the cold symptoms include runny nose, which is accompanied by the low-grade fever, sore throat, headache with or without the cough. While in the allergic rhinitis or the hay fever, there is the no fever. So he was using cold remedies, so it resulted in the rebound nasal congestion, worsening of his symptoms and complicating his hay fever. Furthermore, current studies also suggesting that there is a strong link between the allergic rhinitis and the other immune mediated diseases such as asthma. As his history telling us that he was having the history of the childhood asthma, so there could be the relation in between his allergic rhinitis and the asthma problem. The plan which I would suggest that advise Mr. J A to avoid the allergens, and the best way to avoid the allergens is that pollen count highest is the evening, is highest in the evening, so advise him to close the windows at the night specially. As he was using Vicks Sinex in the Sudafed, so these two should be stopped, because Vicks Sinex contain oxymetazoline and Sudafed contains deutoephedrine. So they are contributing to the rebound effects. I recommend him some non-sedating antihistamines like cetirizine. It is safe because from the other histamines, because other histamines are contraindicating due to the history of the porphyria of Mr. J.A. The dose of the cetirizine could be 10 milligram, one tablet once daily. We can also recommend intranasal corticosteroids for ocular and the nasal symptoms along with cetirizine. In intranasal corticosteroids, we can give triamcinolone acetonide, 2 sprays, 55 microgram per spray in each nostril once daily. I also advise Mr. J.A. to start his allergic rhinitis treatment 4 weeks before the start of the season, depending on which pollen type he is allergic to. The extra notes I would tell about that depending on the severity of the symptoms, the patient can be referred to his physician for allergic testing with a view to desensitization injections once the allergen has been identified. Recent evidence suggests that to manage seasonal allergic rhinitis symptoms, monotherapy rather than a combination of medications from different classes should be used based on lack of superiority of the combination in reducing symptoms. Allergic rhinitis could lead to many complications such as acute or the chronic sinusitis, otitis media, sleep disturbance or apnea, upper respiratory tract infections, asthma, hearing and the speech development impairment. To avoid all these complications, it must be treated properly, and the treatment and the first line treatment is that our the goal of the treatment is that to relieve the symptoms and to avoid the allergens. The LTRAs, montelukast and the zafirulukast, are effective in treatment of the allergic rhinitis, but second generation oral antihistamines and intranasal corticosteroids are the mainstay of the treatment for the most patients. Topical mast cell stabilizers are best used for prophylaxis of the allergic eye symptom. Oral and the intranasal decongestants may limit their long-term use due to the side effects. headache, palpitations, insomnia. These agents are contraindicated in patients with uncontrolled hypertension, severe coronary artery disease. Allergic rhinitis may worsen during pregnancy, so it necessitates that the pharmacological treatment should be started, but risk to benefit ratio must be considered in that. Thank you.